Hello and welcome to the non-Greg Sterlis Greg Sterlis show. Except only the substitutes. I'm your host, the Pamazon. That is me. That's me. That is I.
Yes, and you can't see Penelope, but she's got a fabulous new hairdo.
Oh, well, it's not very fabulous because
it's very
avant-garde. I just kind of do it whatever side she's laying on, and it's not even. But it didn't cost me $1,000, so.
It's just a very different look. She's just a bohemian.
She's new wave.
Yeah,
new wave.
Really. Yeah, she's cat wave. She's a cat. But yeah, she's got a haircut, and well, Penelope doesn't have any complaints about it, so.
No, that is true.
I think even if she was aware of how it looked, she wouldn't care. She'd just be like, well, okay. Can I have a treat now?
Can I have a treat? Yes, that is her main concern. Treats!
Penelope is almost very dog-like. She greets you at the door. She likes to just kind of, like, hang out with you and beg for attention and wants her treats. She'll come and, like, beg for food like the dogs. Although she never eats it if you give it to her. You give her the food and then she looks at it like, what's that? Like, she wants it and she'll sit there begging for it. And you give it to her and she's like, what am I supposed to do with this? And then the dog eats it and she looks mad and she tries to get more. It's like, true. Penelope, you're a cat. Like, cats are kind of known for having, like, these sharp teeth to eat things. And you're just kind of like, well, I'll maybe push it around a little. I'll think about it, I guess. But I don't know what that is. That is Penelope for you. And not the famous Penelope from the Iliad. I don't think Penelope can wait that long.
Well, she is very. She looks a little bit like she was attacked by a pack of gerbils while she was sleeping and they chewed her fur off, but.
Well, gerbils can be nice people. They just aren't good at giving haircuts, I guess. I don't know. But. That's all I can say is Penelope has a new hairdo, and you can't see it, but if you could, it's.
It's definitely a look for you!
Peppy is the only one without a new hairstyle. Moses has been delumped. If anyone is familiar with his lumps. This hat, I like this hat, but I'm thinking maybe I should get like a pork pie hat. I don't know. I feel like with pork pie hats, you gotta get the right one, otherwise they look kind of dumb. I like flat caps. But, I don't know. That's okay. The only one... Oh, hi, Penelope.
I'll put it away.
The only one I definitely don't want is a trilby. I don't really think trilbies look good. I like pork pie caps. I like flat caps.
What's a trilby?
You'd know it if you've seen it. It's like a type of fedora.
Oh, okay.
But it's got a different brim cut. I like hats a lot.
You do like hats a lot.
I don't like too many baseball caps. I like actual baseball helmets. But I'm not super into a lot of baseball caps. I mean, I do wear my janky vintage baseball cap. Provided by Janky Industries.
She was not amused. Can't really see her. There we go. Can't really tell. This is shaved off. But it's all uneven because, you know, I just kind of did it when she would turn.
You just kind of... From, the, you know, the time I... was hired by Janky Industries to retrieve an Aerostar, so I do like that baseball cap, but I don't know. Football helmets I think are like a bad helmet. Bike helmets are fine. I like baseball helmets. I like the old football helmets that were made out of leather.
Oh yeah, yeah.
But the new ones look weird. They're too bulky. But I mean, I guess you gotta have something like that for such an intense sport. Even though, you know, everybody says we're the only ones in the world to call soccer that. It's like, that's not true. They call it soccer in Australia. They call it soccer in Canada. They call it soccer in a good chunk of Africa. They call it soccer in Japan. We're not the only ones, okay? I'd say it's about, like, 15% of the world says soccer. Everybody else says football. But they also call it soccer in Ireland, but not Northern Ireland. So, yeah, anyway. Soccer does not have a helmet because you often have to hit the ball with your head.
Right, yes.
But
volleyball doesn't have a helmet.
Soccer. Yeah, that's true. It's called soccer in New Zealand. I don't know. I hate when people's like, you guys are the only ones who use Fahrenheit. No, we're not. That is not true.
Who else uses it?
There's a couple places in South America. There's a couple places in Africa. And they also use it, for the most part, in Canada and England. They have been trying to force them to switch over, but in everyday life, most people are going to use the standard measurements we use.
Oh, really?
Yes. Oh. They, like, if you're gonna go to England and you say, like, kilometers, not that this is metric, well, I guess it is, but whatever. If you say kilometers, they're just gonna not really know what you're talking about. They really use miles, mostly. Like, they'll probably know generally, but the average person just goes by miles. Like, or, like, you know, if you go to Canada, most people will say, oh, I'm, like, whatever, I'm 5'3", or, you know, they're gonna say that they don't really... I feel like that's a common misconception people say. Like, oh, you guys are the only ones. It's like, but we're not. It's a lot more complicated than that. So shut up.
What's that in old money?
That's a good question. I don't know. I only got 50 squid.
It's quid.
I know, but...
Yeah, you like to say squid.
It's funnier that way. Because I like when LAG's like, yo, I only got like 15 quid. Or squid. And he goes, mm-hmm. They're like, what? Yo, I only got like 15 squid here. And then when he goes to the anti-McDonald's rally, and he thinks that they're protesting it because they started charging 15 pence for ketchup, he's like, yo, that's a big deal. We got to stop this. And they're like, no, it's because they're like terrible. He's like, oh, no. I'll stop getting all this ketchup on my burgers. It's like... Mm-hmm. He's like, Ronald McDonald's got to be stopped.
That Ronald McDonald, he a twat.
I love when he says that. Oh, my
he's
God.
He's a bloody wanker.
Yeah, it's so funny when he goes to Donald Trump and he says, yo, I met Ronald McDonald at my cousin's 15th birthday party. He goes, he's actually a business genius, even though he dresses like a complete prick. Oh, it's so stupid. People are always like, Borat, I do too, but LAG is even funny. But, I don't know. I guess people just don't like the movie. Which, to be fair, the movie was the worst. But.
I always think because Penelope has furry legs. It looks like she has pants on.
Yeah, she kind of does.
She's just got little fur pants on.
Pets just kind of have pants built in. She's a fuzzy gal.
She's super fuzzy. But. I know I got to, like, get the shaver. Get her this way, too. Eventually. There's her furry little pants legs. Spread them out. There we go. That's one little furry pant leg. All right, there you go.
Plunk. I'm trying to think of like other. I mean, this is like the obviously the earlobe typed flat cap. But flat caps came into existence because England wanted by law people to spend more money on wool, so you had to by law have a certain amount of wool you bought every month, and this was the cheapest thing they could come up with.
Was it cap?
Was these like tiny flat caps?
Oh.
So they just by law people had to buy one of these all the time in like the 1300s or something.
They must have been everywhere.
Oh yeah, they were. This is like they're much.
I think those are 1300s.
They are. You can look it up.
Really?
They're. It might even be older. Let me look it up. Sorry, that was a frog.
That was a frog sound.
Let me look up when that edict was from. Because it was created for that specific reason. Because I like the Hat History Channel. I also like the Cheese History Channel.
Mm.
Yeah, flat caps. Oh, and then there's the Newsboy version of a flat cap. I like those too. But.
So while you're looking up your caps, I'm going to tell a funny story. I was supposed to go look at a car today. I saw it on the website. I called the dealer. And actually, when we were in the car yesterday, didn't she say she didn't know where the key was? That she had to find it or something?
I thought she said she had to find it, and then she called you back and said she found it.
Did she? Okay.
But then she must have lost it somehow.
Yeah, because today I was supposed to... go back at 6. They want me to make an appointment. I'm like, what is this shit? This isn't a doctor visit. Just let me fucking show up and look at your goddamn car. But so they made an appointment. And they sent me a text. We lost the key. You can't come and look at the car. We don't have the key.
That's bad.
Yeah. So I'm like, okay. So I'm sitting there. Ding. We have this car instead. I'm like, well, that car is $3,000 more. And it's not the year I wanted that has the good reliability ratings. It's got poop reliability ratings. And so I said, I don't want that car. And then they're like, well, we'll call you back when we find the key.
That's crazy.
I thought that was really funny. I'm
that
like,
is funny. Also, according to the Hat Risk History website, it was during the 1300s, but they don't know the exact year.
Oh, okay.
It said they eventually became associated with working class British and Irish people. I know that. And newsboys. But yes, it was some kind of edict where they basically forced people to have a certain amount of wool.
Hmm.
Because they thought more money needed to go around.
Huh. Well.
That's right. Buy me bloody wool cap, mate. For real.
How long did that last for?
It says they don't know exactly, but that it was brought back in the 1570s, so it must have just been an on and off thing.
I'm just wondering, like, did that put people into the habit of buying those types of caps? And if you go to the thrift store, will there be, like, tons in the UK, will there be, like, tons of those caps because everybody just buys them?
I mean, I think they are. I mean, they were basically, you know, the people that bought them were the poorest people where that was the only thing they could afford. You know, other people who were richer probably bought more things. But that's why they became associated with poor people, basically.
Right.
And, of course, in the U.S., they're pretty much associated with, like, hipsterdom, but I don't care, they look cool.
I don't know that they are anymore, are they? Are they? I don't know.
I don't know. Every time I see anybody mention them, they're like, ew, don't. But it's like, no, I like them, shut up.
Don't.
I remember in the Buffalo Facebook group, everybody's like, ew, I see so many people wearing this, it's so gross.
Well, they look good on you.
It's like, what do you want? Irish people, like, are known for wearing them. Shut up. They're also popular in, like, certain parts of, like...
You're partially Irish.
Yeah, and also, you know, they're worn in, like, other areas. They made their way to Italy. They made their way to, like, Turkey and that entire part of the Mediterranean. They're, like, from England, but the style was all over.
I think you're more Irish than me, despite my red hair.
I love Irish music and stuff. There's so many good Irish songs. I always wanted to do... with my shillelagh under me arm and a twinkle in me eye, I'll be off to Tipperary in the morning. That's such a great song. I love that movie. Darby O'Gill and the Little People. That's such a great movie.
I don't know if I've seen it.
It's really good.
Is it old?
It's from, like, the mid-60s.
Okay.
I think it's... it might be the 50s. Let me look it up. That banshee used to always scare me when I was little. But man, that's such a great movie. Darby O'Gill. 1959.
Oh, okay.
Stars Janet Monroe and Albert Sharp. Sean Connery. Oh, I forgot Sean Connery's in there, but they dubbed him to have an Irish accent because he couldn't do it.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Well,
Yeah, I forgot. It's pretty obvious because he's kind of... It looks so dumb because whenever he talks, he's just some side character, but it's just so dumb looking. Yeah, you got like Darby O'Gill, who's that really old guy, and then the daughter's always like, Dad, what are you doing? You've got to get off of this stuff. And then he falls into the mountain, and all the leprechauns are there, and they like. And then they keep warning him the banshee's gonna come. And
I finally watched the movie Showgirls, which is supposed to be one of the worst movies.
The one from the 90s?
Yeah.
I don't know anything about it.
It is real bad. I gotta concur. It's real bad. Really bad. Really fucking bad.
I remember when it came out, but that's about it.
And nudity, like every... there's lots of nudity. Like, never watch it with any little kids around or anything.
Okay, I'll probably never watch it anyway.
Everyone's naked.
Yeah, no.
Naked.
I'm good. No,
it's not. Yeah, it's definitely not your thing.
I used to have a really great movie called Chihuahua Adventure. Now that's a really good movie.
I mean, what was that about?
It was about this cute little white chihuahua, and he's trying to find, he has a treasure map that he finds.
Mm-hmm.
And they just film this dog going around, and he finds some, a big thing of dog bones.
Well, there you go.
That was a really good movie. I used to watch that like every day. I've never been able to find any information on it. Every time I look online, nobody knows what I'm talking about. I'm pretty sure somebody just made it up and sold it out of the flea market. But I don't care. It was a really good movie. There was a lot of chihuahuas in it.
That makes a good movie. Lots of chihuahuas.
The cover was really cute. It had this chihuahua laying in some grass. I really like chihuahuas a lot.
You do love chihuahuas. Well, but this guy is not a chihuahua.
No, that doesn't mean I don't like other little dogs.
He is a fox terrier mix.
Peppy's my special little guy, but it doesn't mean, you know, I like little dogs in general.
Chihuahuas are just... He did say he was part chihuahua, but the problem with toy fox terriers is they were bred with chihuahuas to make them smaller, so I don't know.
Yeah, who knows? It's so very interesting if you look up the history of chihuahuas. They're like one of the most old breeds ever, and you wouldn't think that these tiny little, like, nothing dogs would be able to last so long, but they're just so intense. You can see how they lasted.
They're very intense. Penelope is not in camera range, but she is asleep on her back, and that was I want to shave her that fur right off. It's
I know,
so
we
satisfying.
Gotta get her. There's only like a few newer world dogs that even existed anymore. I mean, you know, there's those
Chinese,
ones.
The Chinese, I can't say the original pronunciation.
Was that a new world dog?
Oh, no, the old dogs I thought you were talking about.
Oh, no, I was just talking about the dogs from the new world. Most of them died out, sadly, because of all the disease. But somehow those chihuahuas, they hold on. I think there's, I mean, it's not the new world technically, but those Hawaiian dogs. Those.
But chihuahuas are from the same place as Chinese crested, so they held on then if you're...
Are they really, they're not really Chinese then?
No.
Oh, okay.
No. Sholo something. That's the real name.
Here, I can look
it's
up
really
what
long
called.
And I don't know how to say it. Sholo.
Well, aren't they the ones that always posted the ugliest dogs?
Yeah, they always win the ugliest dog
but
contest.
They're cute. Don't be mean to those guys.
And there's another breed of that's bigger that is hairless from Mexico.
Yeah, those
as
ones
well.
Are
those
strange.
Are
they got that
old.
One little band around them.
Yeah, those are very old breed as well. And then
Ketchup is actually from China, which is fascinating.
There are a lot of dogs in China that are very old too, old breeds.
Yeah, their name is
Sholo something or other. I don't know how to say the whole thing.
Yeah, it says that
they're put before Chihuahuas, I believe.
The Chinese crested?
Yeah, Sholo whatever.
It says here that. It's weird. At least according to Wikipedia, it says, although likely Mexico, there are also strange genetic traits that say they might be from North Africa, but it says it's more likely Mexico, but they're not able to prove either one. That's very strange.
Interesting.
So I don't know. It says that they don't really know. It says that it's a mutation. They think it's a mutation of those big hairless dogs.
Oh, okay.
So I don't know, but it says, I don't know. That doesn't make any sense. It says the Spanish explorers found them in the 1500s, but then there still are weird DNA things saying they might be from like North Africa. Whatever. Who knows? I don't know. Strange. I mean,
they used to be on the, you know, the pet finder, the pet thrift store, but...
Oh, I like those guys. They're nice.
They're not on there anymore. You can see the dog trends by what dogs appear on the pet thrift store.
Yeah, you see a lot of certain ones.
Well, there's tons of pit bulls, and my favorite dog is my doggy crush. I look at her every day.
No, she's a nice person.
She seems so good.
I like that baby.
She's a big puppers. I just don't know what would happen with the big puppers. Although, you know, Oliver has gotten every creature to submit to him, no matter its size.
It doesn't matter, I know. I've never seen a dog that doesn't like, ah!
Jesus Christ, what's that thing doing? Crazy demonic sounds he makes.
Yeah, they're just so nuts. I think things are afraid. Even if they attack it, it'll still probably, like, tear it open or something. I mean, it's kind of like a bee or something. Like, they're small, but they're genuinely kind of terrifying.
He's a beast.
Or a spider. Like, you know, you see a spider, it's like, if it's big enough, even though it's tiny, it's still pretty scary. I think it's got that effect.
I'm not that scared of spiders, though, so that doesn't work for me so much.
Well, I guess it just depends on the person. I don't want to see a tarantula.
I held a tarantula.
I don't trust them. Why are they so spiky?
They are spiky. They're very prickly. That is true.
The worst ones to me are those bird-eating spiders. What kind of a spider is big enough to eat a bird? And then there's those crazy ones with, like, the 6-foot leg span. They got, like, those tiny bodies, but they're so long. I hate those guys. I don't trust most, whatever you call those, arthropods.
Arachnids.
No, not arachnids. The thing that's even more...
inclusive?
Yeah, arthropods. Yeah, I don't trust any of those guys.
I mean, I should hate them. I've been bitten by them so many times and really kind of... You know,
they've caused a lot of problems.
Especially when they bit my foot and it swelled up and I had to take antibiotics and I couldn't walk. That was very bad.
Yeah, that brown recluse that got my dad was bad.
Yeah.
I don't trust spiders. I don't trust, like... Oh, my God, those centipedes I saw were terrifying. Centipedes are so gross. They're poisonous, too. Don't mess with centipedes. They're creepy.
Leonardo ate one, and then he was, like, really, like...
Ew.
Yeah, because it was poisonous. I was like, oh my god, he ate it. Oh god, he ate it.
Oh, our cats used to always eat spiders. It was so gross. I remember the one kid, Madeline.
Spiders aren't poisonous. Centipedes are.
Yeah, I guess they're not poisonous unless they bite you. Centipedes are poisonous if you eat them. But I just remember she caught this huge one, and it was still like half alive trying to come out of her mouth, and she's just like... crunching it, and it's and it was huge. It was like half the size of her face. Oh,
I didn't know centipedes were poisonous at that point when he ate it, and then he was kind of like,
what's those huge ones that live in the ocean? Those creep me out. And then there's those ones that like get to like 8 feet long. It's like, I'm good, they're creepy.
They're bugs,
they're like some kind of like sea bug thing.
Well, there are also giant centipedes, right?
Yeah, they get up to, like, I think, like, 4 feet long, and they're pretty, like, big, too.
Which is a nice part of being here. And,
you know, the North in general, thankfully, does not have a lot of bug problems. The North, the further up north you go, the less buggy it gets.
Although global warming has brought a lot of them up here farther. Yay.
I do wish we had some cloudberries, though. I keep watching these videos on cloudberries.
What's a cloudberry?
They're like these...
I'm checking the weather for tomorrow.
Berries that are supposedly like the best berry ever, but they
It's going to be smoky.
Yeah.
It's going to be smoky again.
But they don't grow them commercially, and it's like...
Tomorrow's supposed to be the worst smoky day.
Are you kidding me? I went into work today to avoid the smoky. Son of a...
It was fairly clear today.
It was. They said today was going to be really worse than yesterday, but...
Yeah, it wasn't bad at all because I was able to do it with my dad and go and work on
them. Well, since it might rain tomorrow, when it rains, it washes the particulate matter out of the air.
I think that's what saved me today.
So hopefully it rains. God damn it, really?
Because I got to go to the DMV.
I don't want to go back into work. Because
I wanna.
I'm not getting paid to be there, number one.
And it's terrible to be there regardless.
And since I'm not getting paid, I'd like to do some things that I need to do. And it's very sad. There's nobody there, and it's very empty, and there's other things, too, that make it very sad.
It's a very terrible situation.
I did not see a single person today. Not one. Not one.
I'm surprised it's not cloudy there too, or foggy.
Well, no, but there's, you know, the windows don't open, so they have to have some sort of air system. So that's why I went.
The windows don't open? That seems crazy.
No, they don't open. No, that was always something I thought about when So we had that scare where they're like, stay in your room, shut the door, blah, blah. You know. So I locked the door. I had a piece of metal that fit perfectly over that particular door, so that even if you shot the lock out, there's this huge hunk of metal you can't get through. And I have a fire extinguisher. I took the pin out, and I had the fire extinguisher ready to go. And I'm like, you know, that get just, in the back of the room, and if anything happens, bust out the windows and jump out.
That just seems like a fire hazard in general, and I have the windows open. Every time the fire people came to the school to tell you things, the whole thing was how to get out the window.
Really?
Yeah, they always had the one emergency window in every room so you could get
out.
Wow,
really?
Yeah.
Oh, that is interesting. So, we have no emergency windows.
Yeah, there was even in rooms, you know, that didn't really have regular windows, there was always the one emergency window, so, you know, I thought it was some kind of law. That's crazy. It seems like it
made
sense.
That would seem like something that should be possibly a law.
Yeah, it seems dangerous to not have at least one window.
No, nothing opened. Nothing opened.
Jeez, that's crazy.
Yeah, nothing opened. It was funny because I had locked my one student out and someone's knocking on the door. I'm like, who is it? And they're like, I'm not here to shoot up the room. It's just me.
Oh, of course. That's what they would say.
It is, but I recognized her voice. It was pretty distinctive, so I was like, oh, okay.
That's how they get you, I'll tell you what.
Well, there was no person. It was just a false alarm. Yeah, it was just a false... My new room has a fucking window in it, and it's made of wood. That's not stopping anybody. What the fuck? What the fuck?
Yeah, that's dumb.
And the windows in that room, it's on the second floor, and they overlook the cafeteria. Ugly.
Delicious.
Ugly. Oh, no, not delicious.
Why do you have windows?
I wish the cafeteria was delicious.
Look into that.
To be fair, you know, they're really up against it trying to deliver at this really low price point, and they do the best they can. I will say that.
That was the only thing ECC had was the fact that the food was good because of all the people learning to cook there.
Yeah, we don't.
There's not a cooking program at that school?
I will tell you later.
Oh, okay.
I'll talk about it later.
Because the ECC...
There isn't.
Food program was pretty good.
Yeah, Jamestown Community College also had one as well. And that was pretty fun because there was different cafeterias with different specialties. And no, this is... I mean, I...
Tasty.
It's just, you know,
little
low price point trying to deliver what they can. And they do work. I've got nothing against the cafeteria and the people working there. They try very hard.
There, Mother, I will say the Buffalo, the people that used to have out the senior meals for free for seniors, they desperately need people to take advantage of it because they don't want to lose out on it. So now they're making it available for anyone. So anybody of any age can go get the meals at the Tosh Collins Center.
Where is the Tosh Collins Center?
It's on Kaz in South Buffalo. The whole Tosh Collins Center is really nice in general. People should take advantage of it. It's like a rec center, but for all ages. There's an ice rink. There's a basketball rink. There's like games. There's like a you know a stand. You can buy hot chocolate and stuff.
Maybe I should go look at some free meals and then.
Yeah, they're for all ages now.
Maybe I can afford the more expensive car. Eat free meals.
I like them. I really especially like those tortellinis they make. Obviously,
I can't have them.
But those tortellinis are really good. And even the Polish sausage, I cooked it up with an egg, and it was a really good Polish sausage. What else did I have? I had the omelet was really good. That spicy omelet. That was. I liked them. The only one that I thought was kind of bad was the Italian sausage one. It just didn't have any flavor.
Oh yeah, that's bad.
But yeah, they're always looking for people to go get their stuff because, like, nobody ever gets them, and they're always afraid of getting, like,
they're
cut.
Oh, well, okay.
So now they've made it available for all ages instead of you used to have to...
Do they heat it up and you eat it there, or you just take it home?
You can heat it up there, but most people just, you know. You can only get one, not one a week, but you can only get up to 10 a week.
Oh, okay.
But you can get them frozen or eat them there.
All right. Thanks for the helpful info.